We need the coke.
Yeah, but I've got friends outside can put it together. But how are we supposed to get it in?
I'll have a think about it while I'm fixing my new cellmate.
What's wrong with her?
Friend of Rita's. It's the last thing we need, her spying on me all the time.
How are you going to get rid of her?
I'm not going to try. It's easier just to make trouble between them, force them apart. Possibly even get her on our side.
Jeez, nothing devious about you, is there?
I really must go, Andrew. Thanks again for the game.
Thank you. Joan, I was thinking if you're not doing anything this evening, would you like to have dinner with me?
No, I'm sorry, I can't.
Oh, that's a pity. It's just that I haven't been to a restaurant for a while and I find you most enjoyable company.
It was the freak organized the gang and got Slasher killed.
Murder and bitch!
What are you going to do?
First I talked the screws into letting me speak to Roach's brother.
So?
He's in the gang. They're going to organize a nice little surprise for that
gun of basher.
Nah, wheel stands on her face, eh?
What, Reed?
She's so keen on fires. Let's see how she likes her own bloody house burned down.
Oh, beauty!
I would like you to arrange for a sentence to be increased by whatever means is necessary.
Is that all? Oh, you're living in a fairyland, Mrs. Ryan. The system doesn't work that way.
I believe it could, with your help.
Why would I want to help you?
Because I'm offering you $10,000, that's why.
Now I could report you for this.
I dare say you could, but I doubt it. My son is hell-bent on marrying a criminal, and I'll do anything to prevent that.
In similar circumstances, I probably feel the same. However, it has nothing to do with me or Wentworth. Goodbye, Mrs. Ryan, and good luck.
Miss Ferguson, the offer still stands. $10,000 is a lot of money for doing what comes naturally.
If Miss Ferguson had something to do with Slasher's death, then report it to the police.
Why? So they can decorate her.
You haven't been around much, have you, dearie?
Oh, enough to know that violence brings more violence. Don't you ever ask yourself where it's going to end?
It ends when I bury the freak.
It's mindless revenge.
Bull! It's do-it-yourself justice. It carved a hole right out of my guts when I lost him, and Ferguson's going to pay for it.
What do you want me to do, Reed? Just no, name it.
And this is not going to leave a
shut up,
are
you? I need a couple of
them. Oh, I'm in.
Right, all right. The rest of you see nothing, you hear nothing, understood? Okay, so that's it. I would stop your sulking, Ida. You've done enough for one day.
I could have. Where you going, love?
Oh, I'm going to be doing.
Oh, good. Wait for me, will you? I'm breech right. I'm buggered.
Yeah, you look exhausted.
Yeah, so I should. I done over the milk bar. Drove the getaway car, clobbered a copper and resisted arrest. And I tell you what, love, I'm juicy for. Hey, what do you think you're doing?
Taking a load off your mind.
Oh, Lord, I'm not that bloody
well fated, you crafty old tart, you didn't everything else.
Don't
What's going on in the rec room?
Nothing.
Don't lie. Janet told me Rita's up to something.
So what if she is? It's got nothing to do with you.
Everything Rita does has something to do with me.
Well, then ask her yourself. I mind my own business.
Well, that's a relief.
What is?
Living in such close quarters, you could overhear something and be tempted to tell Rita. I can't tell you how much I'd make you regret that.
I didn't tell her about the knife trick you pulled, if that's what you're getting at.
Good.
But don't push me. Oh, you'll see, I can look after myself.
I doubt it. It's your first time inside, isn't it? You'll learn. If you don't, Connors and her gang will make sure you do. And here you're on your own, and you stay that way until you get sick of being bashed and humiliated. Then you learn to play it Connors' way. Get some muscle behind you.
She's not like that.
No. I can personally verify it, Waters.
She really is exhausted, Mrs. Pringle.
After seeing her charge sheet, I'm not surprised. I still think she could have managed the walk to the dining room.
And I'll stick that muck. I'm not what I used to be, dear. I'm all tackered out, you know.
Perhaps I should take this back and get you some nice chicken soup.
Oh, no, she'll be right. You could handle real tucker, couldn't you, Ida?
Only in a drip, do you?
Come on, you two get along to the dining room.
Oh, as soon as we've seen to Ida, Mrs. Pringle.
Well, don't be too long. The bell has gone. I hope you're feeling better soon, Brown.
Thank you. What a pleasure for me. To the minute I see her.
You should try it on Davis next time.
Yeah, I will, love.
Come on, I'm hungry. I could eat a horse. See you later, Auntie.
See you later, love.
Look, you go on. I'm not really hungry.
What's the problem?
Oh, it's this business with the freak. It's got me all churned up.
It's got me revved up. I give my eye teeth to be there with them.
Yeah, what happens if she guesses you had something to do
with
it?
She won't have to guess. She'll know. I made sure of that.
She'll come after you.
That's what I'm counting on.
Oh, Rita, it scares me.
Oh, come on, cupcake. When this hits the fan, you'll be tucked up safe in bed, okay?
And what about you? There's no telling what she'll do to you.
She won't get the chance, believe me. I'll save you something in case you change your mind.
Yeah, just about. Better go and check, she's still there.
Right. This for Ferguson?
Yeah, from Rita and Slasher. Gonna light up a life.
Well, I'm glad you came, Joan. You see, I was a bit worried because, well, I felt I'd put you ill at ease for some reason.
My fault. I'd had a tense day.
Yeah, I understand. It's not always easy to leave a job behind, particularly one like yours. Hey, that's probably the reason you kept going in the rough this afternoon.
That wasn't the job. Anyway, I told you yesterday they were just lucky shots. Now, no excuses. What I need is practice.
Good. Well, that's easy fixed. I tell you what, we'll get a refill, and then we will drink to the future of the dynamic duo of the Dorset Golf Club.
I hope you don't expect me to clean up the mess you left in there.
Yeah, this lot too.
You have to creep up on us like that?
She's still down the pub. Oh, have a drink, why don't you?
Got one.
Hey, what are you looking for?
Porn. I bet she's got it.
Yeah, be the type. Hey, we load this stuff into the U. There's no point wasting it.
Later.
Yeah, we've got time.
It was the cutest little thing. But you can't...
Honey, beer goes straight through me. Won't be long.
Well, Lurleen, it's been quite a while.
Oh, I'm terribly sorry, dear, but I think you're mistaken. My name's Lorelei Wilkinson.
Your name's Lurleen Snook. Still working the same con, eh? What brought you down from Queensland?
Just wanted to change.
You seem to be doing all right.
Keith. Oh, he's wonderful, Miss Ferguson.
Mr. Wright again.
He loves me for what I am.
Really?
He doesn't know a thing about me. Now, you won't say anything, will you?
Same old Lurleen, still building castles.
Please, Miss Ferguson.
Lorelei, you look wonderful. Now, you remember, lunch, hmm?
Who's that?
Oh, just an old friend of the family's.
Another drink?
Yes, please. A double.
The only ones you really have to watch are Kath and Janet.
Why?
Well, I think they're dangerous.
Yeah, well, you think Mervyn's dangerous.
Shut up.
What's Kath in for? Oh, she killed a kid. Now she's teamed up with Williams, the meanest bitch going. And Reet wants you to stay away from both of them, okay?
In a two-before cell?
Yeah, well, I'm glad it's you and not me. Hey, watch what you say. She's a real lagger.
Do you really think she's dangerous, Jules?
No, she's a wimp.
She is not. She went after Rita and Miss Ferguson with gym weights, and she meant it. And she tried to stab Rita, too.
Oh, it was a scratch. God, you exaggerate.
Well, what about Janet, then?
So what about her?
Well, she killed Lou Kelly, didn't she?
She got in a lucky hit.
Who was Lou Kelly?
The meanest bitch going.
Yeah, and some lucky hit. Janet got all the way up to Solitary to finish her off, and Kelly was tough, Roach. She killed Alice's mother and brother, and they weren't the first. Oh, I'm sorry. I didn't mean to make you nervous or anything.
Oh, come on, Jules. Hey, you're not scared of those two, are you?
Hell no. Hung around with tougher birds than them two.
Yeah. Anyway, after tonight, the freak will be gone, so no worries, eh?
What's going to happen tonight? Reet didn't actually say, did she?
Well, I don't know. I was going to ask you. I thought you and her been such old mates, she might have said something.
No?
Oh, well. No, and Reet, whatever it is, it's going to be good, eh?
Did I ever tell you about the Nullarbor in 1945?
You've already told us four times.
Oh, God, it was a long one, so it takes a lot of telling. Did I ever tell you about Kalgoorlie?
Yeah, but only twice.
Oh, God, it was rough as guts in that town, you know. There's a blue in every pub and the fellas was all half tanked. Oh, jeez, it was a beautiful place, that.
Yeah, me and Slash did Kalgoorlie. Just the two of us. We did some weed, watched the sun go down, and we got stuck into it right out there in the desert.
Well, all rested, Brown?
Yes, thank you, dear. Thanks to you, dear.
Yes, I'm sure. Take it easy, anyway.
You look a bit tired yourself, Mrs. Pringle. Isn't this Miss Ferguson's shift?
Oh, no, no. Miss Ferguson comes on later.
Yeah? Must have got it stuffed up. Could have sworn this was her stint.
No, no, not till 9:30. Oh. Now, why don't you two move along and let Brown here get some rest, hey?
Oh, they're all right, thank you, dear. This is such a comfort to me.
9:30, eh?
Ain't it about your time you told us what's going on?
Yeah, get Lex.
I hope you know what you're doing with it.
Ever known me not to?
Never, baby, never.
I really must be thinking about going home. It's not long until the shift starts.
Oh, I'm sorry. Here I've been hogging the conversation. I completely forgot the time.
I've enjoyed every minute of it.
Good night, Joan.
Oh, good night, Lorelei.
Is she a friend of yours?
Well, not quite. More a professional acquaintance.
Oh, she has something to do with the penal system.
Hmm, the wrong side.
Oh, I'm prying, aren't I? Sorry.
No, no, not at all. No, it was years ago in Queensland. She's a con woman with enough aliases to fill a country phone book. But she was a friend of someone quite close to me. Shall we go?
Mm. Hello? Could you hold on a moment, please? Is there a Jaron Ferguson in the room? Jaron Ferguson?
Yes. Thank you. Jaron Ferguson?
We're holding awake. For Slasher. And it's at your place, Freak. You got a nice place here, Freak. Everything but an open fire. And we're gonna fix that up right now.
Let it rip sharp.
Joan, please don't misunderstand, but I hope you'll stay here until you make other arrangements.
Thank you.
And if it's a question of money, I'd like
you to... Thank you, but no.
Well, I suppose it's at least something that we save these few things before the...
Before everything was completely destroyed? I suppose I should be grateful for vigilant neighbours.
Could you rest?
Could you?
And you haven't any idea who telephoned you?
No.
Oh, well, I dare say between the police and the fire brigade, they'll come up with something. Though it's pretty obvious it's tied in with your job.
You never get away from Wentworth. You walk away from your shift, but you can't afford to let your guard drop. I have to phone a cab.
A cab?
Yeah, I start work at 9:30.
You can't go to work tonight. You're shocked. You need to rest.
I need to be at work on time and in top form.
That's ludicrous. Surely someone else can do the job.
It's not the job. It's the challenge.
Ma'am. I need to sneak in. She's wide awake. You all right?
Mm-hmm. Blood pressure's up a bit. Nothing to worry about.
Lord, it's fine. Beautiful girl.
And Keith, had a good night.
Yeah, great.
How's my little Alice? Did you chase a little white bunny today?
Alice.
Oh, she was Alice in Wonderland today. And yesterday she was Dorothy and went over the rainbow.
And tomorrow she'll probably be Cinderella and she'll go and live with seven little men.
That's Snow White. She's not going to be Cinderella. She had to work too hard, didn't she? She's going to be Sleeping Beauty tomorrow.
She's no Sleeping Beauty, believe me.
She's been giving you a hard time, Gran.
Same as usual. Mm. I'm warning you, you're making a rod for your own back with that little one.
Mum.
You keep on running to her every time she cries. She's going to cry every time she wakes up. That's what she's been doing tonight.
You didn't let her cry?
Well, no. But she's a real night owl. And I'm not anymore.
Come on, I'll put you to bed.
No, I'll put her to bed. You stay with Keith.
No, I won't be long.
Don't be silly, dear. Keith doesn't want to sit with me. I'll put her to bed.
Settle the argument. I'll put her to bed.
Come on. You want her to read to her.
Well, I can read.
He's a good man, Lurleen.
Lorelei. Oh, awful name, Gran.
Sorry, pet. I mean, he's good for Zoe as well as you.
Yeah, I know. He's lovely. You all right, Gran, really?
Of course I am. Now, you go in with Keith. Go on. Off you go.
She doesn't show.
She'll be here right on time.
What if she doesn't walk into it?
I'm telling you, she will.
But what if she don't?
Listen, she'll be here on time and she'll come right to me, I guarantee it. You just make sure you're both ready when I need you.
Oh, sure, betcha. Sure.
Move along, ladies. Come on, hurry it up, please. Thank you.
Really sorry.
Forget it.
This joint's going to blow tonight. I hope you're keeping out of it, kid.
Well, Rick don't want me in it anyway. I'm sharing with Kath. She don't trust her.
Good. Is that Sheila as bad as Rita reckons? Ain't giving you no trouble, is Sheila?
No. Give her hell if she did.
Lock up in 5 minutes, ladies. Now, you feeling better, Brown?
Yes, much better. And, you know, I'm a bit shaky, you know, but I'll manage.
Yes, I'm sure you will. Come on, Waters, back to yourself.
Mrs. Pringle, what are my chances of staying in here tonight, eh?
Oh, about the same as booking into the Windsor. Now, hurry up.
Maxwell is giving you a hard time, isn't she, love? Now, come on. This is your Auntie Ida.
No, honest. I don't like her, that's all.
Look, you tell her that if she so much as lays a hand on you, I'll kick her backside until her nose bleeds. Come on, love.
Hello, not like you to be late.
Couldn't get a cab.
Well, Joyce tried calling you, but your phone was disconnected.
Yes, I've reported it.
Is anything wrong? Why should there be? Well, I mean, it's unusual for you to be late, and I don't think I've ever known you to arrive out of uniform. I just thought something might be...
What?
Well, wrong.
Huh?
I could start your rounds for you while you're changing, if you like.
I'll do the rounds myself, thank you.
What about the baby?
Look, it's gonna be all right. The Rick's the one that's gonna be getting it, not me.
What if it all goes wrong and what happens afterwards?
Jesus, Jesus, please.
You're getting me all jumpy. It's gonna be all right, I tell you. Be careful.
Thank you.
Geez, you really done it. Oh, she made the bloody time.
I do wish you wouldn't. It's only half of what the bitch deserves.
Myself. You get a bit like that at my age, you know. Mm. Oh, pardon me. It's them onions.
Yes, well, good night.
Good night. You're nice, thoughtful young girls. How did I go?
Oh, great. Come on, let's move it. Good one, Arts.
Where are you going?
Tell me tomorrow.
You want one for me, will you?
Tell her you called. Of course not. No trouble at all.
All quiet on the Western Front.
Good. Listen, I know what's up with Joan.
Sorry?
Joan. Why she had to get that new uniform?
Oh, why?
A friend of hers just rang and he said her house has burnt down.
Oh, you're joking.
That's what he said.
When?
Tonight, just before she came here.
Oh, it must be some sort of practical joke.
Didn't sound like it.
She wouldn't be here if her house had burnt down.
Well, she did seem pretty uptight.
Has she said anything?
Oh, the guy sounded genuine. He's worried about how she's going and thinks she should be resting.
I agree. I mean, if it is true, she must be feeling terrible. Where is she?
On rounds.
Well, I didn't see her, but if it is true, I'll go and find her. We can always cover for her, can't we?
Fine.
Still, you bitch. Oh. I hate you to fall over before we're ready.
Oh. What'd she say?
I think she wants us to get on with it. You ready?
Yeah.
Okay. One, two.
And get screw. You want to play games, do you?
Come on, Lurch. Drag her back. Okay, Lurch, grab her feet. No more games, Lurch. Time for the big drop. Lurch! I think she wants to say goodbye.
Oh, come on,
hold on there.
Still got no manners, Leach.
That's better. You don't want to die, do you? Do you? And neither did Slasher, you stinking bitch!
Oh, hell, we don't really let her go!
Yeah, well, maybe we should.
Hey?
It's okay, I think she's learned her lesson.
Come on, let's drag her back.
Oh. Very lucky, Ferguson. This would be too quick, too easy. You see, we're going to let you go. Because you're never going to have another peaceful day as long as you live.
you cross me ever again. And I'll let the gang know you fixed it for Slasher. And then wherever you are, they'll find you. You're gonna be dead meat, Ferguson. After they've had their fun. Then they'll kill you. Think about it.
She knows.
Yeah, gorgeous, scared less.
So she
should
be wants to
battle
on
the
gang can have her.
I should let him do it anyway.
Not yet. I want her around here so I can rub her face in it.
What if she does dob us in,
Reed? I doubt it. But it won't be long before we know for sure which way she'll swing.
What do you mean?
I've still got her keys. If she comes to get them without kicking up a stink, we'll be home.
I'll be keeping every bloody thing I've got crossed, I can tell you.
Help!
Let's get out of here.
It's done. Maybe.
Oh, there you are. I've been looking everywhere for you.
Why?
Somebody called and said that your house had been burnt down. We didn't know whether to believe it or not.
Yeah, you can believe it.
Oh, no wonder you look so dreadful. Look, would you like to go home? We can arrange. Oh, yes, of course. I'm sorry. Have you got somewhere to stay?
Yes, thank you. If you'll excuse me, I've got work to
do. Oh, but you don't look at all well.
Don't be stupid. Oh, there's enough check through there.
Oh, but that's not on your rounds.
No, I thought I heard a noise, but it was nothing.
Oh. No wonder I couldn't find you. Look, why don't you come and have a coffee?
No. Oh, all right. When I finish my rounds.
Oh, that'll help you to relax quite a lot. Oh, dear. Dreadful thing to have happened.
Go to sleep, Nance.
Oh, you must be joking.
All right, but when she comes in, you know nothing about it, okay?
But...
Play possum, and that's an order. What worries me is she won't put up with this sort of blackmail for long.
So bad luck if she doesn't.
Oh, Rita. Look, she as good as killed Slasher. Now she's paying for it, so shut up about it, will you? Sleep. Now.
Did you forget something?
The keys.
Come and get him.
Don't push me, Connors.
Don't you push me!
Don't forget the security gate. You don't want anyone finding it open and saying you're slacking on the job.
Good one, eh, Nance?
Oh, I wish we'd had the video there. The look on the freak's bloody priceless.
Yeah, but I nearly tickled it. God, I've got a fright.
Why, well, hurt again?
Look at the phone we missed out on.
Oh, God, there's no doubt about you, Reed. You're a bloody little...
It's amazing what a few threats will do.
Yeah, I reckon the freak could do anything to stop a bloke getting his mitts on her.
Did you go all green when you said the gang had had their way with her?
I thought she'd dump her tea there again. Something went down last night. I don't know what it was, but something did. I heard them talking about it in the shower, but they shut up as soon as I came in.
Look, I really couldn't care. Have you done anything about that coke?
Hey, keep it down, will you? Well, I'm going to arrange for my sister to visit.
Today, I hope.
As soon as I can.
Well, it'd better be soon. We've got to get moving as soon as possible.
Reckon I don't know.
Then act like it.
Against the wall,
freak's out cold on the floor, and Joyce is looking through the purple. Suddenly, the freak gives this groan.
And this one says, oh, pardon me.
You know what, silly bitch, Borden? Trust and screw not to know the difference between a groan and a burp.
I don't know why they don't. They're all full of hot air, right?
They're right, they are, really. Well, children, I'm off to do me sit-ups.
Aye?
Better get rid of me Foster's gorgeous.
Oh,
see
ya.
We could go after the old girl and thump it out of her. You're very smart. Then we'd have the whole lot of them down on us. We need time.
I want to know what's going on.
Look, the only important thing is that we get that cocaine in here, and at least we'll have something to bargain with.
Well, there's no guarantees my sister will agree to it.
It's up to you to make sure she does.
I can only do me best, can't I?
Miss Ferguson, you shouldn't be here.
Good morning, Governor. I'm fine, really.
You could have fooled me. Go home.
After my shift.
It was a double shift to start with. It's too long, especially under the circumstances.
All I need is a short break.
Apart from anything else, you must have things to attend to. Insurance.
I have phoned the insurance company. I'm waiting for them to call me back.
I really should force you to go.
If I say I'm up to working, then I am.
All right. Are you changing your
mind? I won't.
I know you said you had somewhere to stay, but if it's only temporary, Mervyn and I do have a spare room and we...
Well,
I'm only trying to help.
Why? You all treat me like a neurotic, and then when something like this happens, you're bending over backwards offering help. At least be consistent.
Oh, well, just because
that'll
we
have...
That'll
be haven't... for me. Ferguson.
Yeah. Oh, well, thank you for calling back so promptly. Yeah, it's about my fire insurance. Hmm? Oh, I gave the details of the claim to the girl when I called. But your records must be wrong. My premiums are paid up. I didn't let it lapse. No, it was posted a good 6 months ago. You must have received it by now. Oh, I remember clearly. I wrote the cheque and I got a friend to post it and... Yes, I'm still here. I've just realised what must have happened. Look, couldn't your records be wrong? I see. I don't suppose there's anything I can do. Oh, I didn't think so. Thank you.
What is it?
Not covered. I wrote the cheque. I gave it to Terry to post. Obviously she didn't.
Oh, Joan, I am so sorry.
I thought she'd done all the damage she could.
What does it mean?
I've got nothing. Will you excuse me?
Oh, yes. Yes, of course.
Here we are, sweetheart. This is a magic spoon. It can turn anything into yummy, yummy food. Even yucky old breakfast cereal. Look, Mummy will have a go first. Here we are. Mm-mm. Just like ice cream. Your turn. Here we go. Here we go. See?
It is a magic spoon, isn't it?
Oh, you shouldn't trick the little thing like that. Magic spoons.
Ah, no harm is it? It is a magic spoon. Would you like me to tell you the whole story about the princess and the magic spoon?
Mind you, a few magic spoons would help cut down on the grocery bills.
Oh, don't start again. Granny's always going on about horrible old money, isn't she?
Horrible old money?
Well, it is if you haven't got it.
Oh, I was going to say, I never thought I'd see the day that you'd call it horrible.
Oh, I think Uncle Keith will be able to buy us all sorts of lovely things.
Now, don't you go spending all his money and scare him off like the others. He's a good man, Lorelei.
Oh, I know. And this time, do you know, I think we've really found our Prince Charming. You even like him too, don't you, Zoe?
Are you sure? Or is it just fairyland again?
Oh, no, Mum. I love him. Cross my heart, hope to die.
I hope so. For your sake, love. You deserve it.
Right? You should see the doctor. I told you to see the doctor last week, Mum.
It's just a cough.
Yeah, every morning for months.
So, a touch of bronchitis, nothing to worry about. Maybe I need one of those magic spells you keep telling Zoe about. You finish up here. I'll get it.
Granny is naughty, isn't she? Ah, oh, she really should see a doctor. Now eat up, or you might be like that princess who had everything that she could wish for. Beautiful clothes, dazzling jewels, luxury furs. But she couldn't eat anything that the palace cook made for her. So the king got very worried. So he got all his knights together around the table.
It's for you, love.
Lorelei Wilkinson, alias Vanetta Maguire, Samantha Demone, Larlene Snook, and others.
No crime in a girl having more than one name, is there?
Stops life getting boring, hey?
Exactly. What can I do for you?
You can accompany us to the station, Miss Wilkinson.
What for?
A little matter of impersonation and theft.
Oh, love.
Yeah. Well, that's about it. Oh, no. McCormick has asked whether she could be rostered onto work. Said she was getting bored with nothing to do.
Fine by me.
Yes, I'm sure it would be. So I've rostered her onto laundry duties. I wonder whether the women have heard about Joan's house being burnt down.
What makes you think they might have?
It's just their reaction when Joan appeared at muster.
Oh, I don't see how they could have heard. Is there something I should know?
No. I'm probably just seeing things that aren't there. There is a possibility.
There certainly is if the police prove arson. Joan hasn't heard?
Well, not that she's told me.
You know, even after everything she's done lately, I still feel sorry for her.
Guess we're just suckers.
Or saints.
Suckers.
Oh, well. She's tough. She'll survive.
Doesn't she always?
So I said, up you, mate, and according meeting.
What are you doing here?
I'm on skip, Miss Ferguson.
And I'm taking it easy. I had a hard night.
You wanted something?
Get back to work.
Don't go too far, Rita.
Oh, come on. Geez, you and Nancy make a good pair, the Glum sisters. That's better. Trust the old reek. No flies on me, eh?
So when do you reckon the wedding will be, now he's got the license?
Well, we've decided we're going to wait till I get out of here.
Just put him in your face. Better watch
him. Now, stop it. I'm not going to start worrying again. He says he loves me and I believe...
Atta girl, Chook. Show a bit of spunk.
Mrs. Ryan, Joan Ferguson, about your offer. Up it to 12,000 and I'll consider. Don't worry. Egbert's got no hope.
And what's your name, eh, cutie? It takes a while for mum to dress, doesn't it?
Lorelei likes to look her best.
Especially in front of the beak, eh? Sorry, that was a cheap shot.
She's been seeing such a nice man. Things were looking good.
Wrong time for the past to catch up, eh?
She didn't do it.
No, of course she didn't.
Now I find cucumber even better. Surely your union could do something about those awful uniforms. Really, they're so dull, aren't they? Well, here we are, all ready.
You're pretty chirpy, considering.
Oh, hey, Sarah. Can I say my goodbyes?
Yeah, sure. Make them quick.
Come on. Come on, my beautiful girl. You'll be okay, won't you?
I've mucked through before.
Will you tell, I had to go away for work?
You took a bail, weren't you?
Maybe not with my record.
Did you do this one?
2 years ago, though. You'd hardly think it'd count, would you?
Oh, some of those cops just never give in.
Look after Zoe. And visit me loads. Do you hear? Don't you cry, darling. Mummy's going away to the Wicked King's dungeons. It's only for a little while. And you know what? If the Vale Fairy is good to her, she could be back this afternoon.
I wouldn't count too much on the Vale Fairy if I were you.
You never know. Could be a happy ending. I'm ready.
I left a message for her to come and visit. I can't do much more.
No, I guess not, as long as she gets the message.
I don't see why not. I left her with her boyfriend.
She got good contacts. She won't have any trouble getting her hands on it, will she?
Nah, she's been dealing for years. Like a bitch didn't get caught. I did.
Get out, Williams.
We're talking.
I said get out unless you want to cop a charge.
Catch you later.
What have I done wrong now?
Who said you've done anything wrong?
What's the problem?
I've heard through my sources that Connors and her gang aren't your favourite people.
So?
They're not mine either. And I have decided that between the two of us, we're going to get rid of them once and for all.
He used to give me roses. I wish he could again. But that was on the outside. And things were different then. On the inside, the sun still shines, and the rain falls down. But the sun and rain are prisoners too, when morning comes around. Last night I dreamed we were together, sharing all the love we'd known, till I had to face the nightmare of waking up alone. On the inside, the roses grow. They don't mind the stony ground, but the roses here are prisoners too. When morning comes around.